Hey, I'm Rhinne, and I'm making this guide specifically to call out Verlisify for spreading misinformation which can be toxic for new players. In his guide, he mentions multiple incorrect things to do on Lucario, which I, as the best Lucario in North America, feel the need to point out. So in this guide, I'll be pointing out exactly what he said that is incorrect and telling you guys how to actually play said character. First, we're going to talk about items. Now let me ask you guys, which do you believe is more important? 40% max HP to both you and an ally, or 2% move speed and 10 damage on an ability that does 500 damage already? Bad players like Verlisify will tell you that items like attack weight and float stone are good, but in reality, they add negligible damage and you sacrifice a lot of utility to run them. That said, here are the items you should be running on Lucario. First item is going to be Buddy Barrier. Buddy Barrier provides 40% max HP for yourself and an ally, which is game breaking. They could half the HP from it and it would still be overpowered. The second item you're going to be running is Focus Band. That's another 40% HP for yourself. Once again, basically a second Buddy Barrier. I don't think I need to explain how broken that is. The third item you're going to be running is Score Shield. You're going to use Score Shield to abuse Lucario's early game pressure so you can dunk on the enemy to gain level advantages, and then use said level advantages in order to be able to contest them at their mobs and steal those to deny them EXP and give yourself even more EXP to be able to snowball. On top of this, it makes it so when you're in the split push, characters like Eldegoss or Snorlax won't be able to stop your dunks, and then anyone coming from the pad as well will also not be able to stop your dunks. Secondly, we will talk about skills. In his video, Verlisify tells us to use Extreme Speed because it has the tools to make Lucario get to the high end. First of all, this is extremely untrue. No high-end Lucario uses Extreme Speed, and I know this because I've played against all of them. It is directly inferior to Power Up Punch because Power Up Punch gives you insane early game one-shot potential. It gives you 30% damage reduction during the charge of it. It has Unstoppable once you hit level 11, so you can break past tanks like Snorlax and his wall, as well as characters like Ninetales who have a lot of CC. Extreme Speed has the big weakness of being vulnerable to said CC as well, especially at the later stages of the game. If you get CC during Extreme Speed, you will put it on a 9-second cooldown, and now you will have to use Bone Rush to get it back, meaning that you're losing two resets from the Bone Rush, one from the actual damage, and then one from the port, in order to get your Extreme Speed back and be useful. Whereas if Power Punch were to get cancelled, it would go on a 6-second cooldown, which is much more realistic to get back, and can also be instantly brought back with Bone Rush, and instantly brought back with Aura Sphere. Given the amount of CC present in the game at the moment, it makes it seem really bad to take, does it not? Power Punch also has much better split potential, given that you can walk out of 1v4s when they try to collapse on you, because they won't be able to CC you, because you will be unstoppable, and then they will also be doing 30% less damage, which makes it very difficult to kill you through your Steadfast Shield, your Focus Band, and your insane mobility. So let's ignore everything that Clown has to say and move on to how to use your abilities. So the first ability you will be leveling up is Quick Attack. Quick Attack is quick, fast damage used to execute mobs in the early game. So when a mob gets low, like so, you can use Quick Attack to hit it and execute it very quickly. Your second ability is Meteor Mash. It is good CC early game. It can be used to knock people back into your team, like so. And it can also be chained with Quick Attack in order to burst mobs early and do a lot of damage to secure kills, like so. It will also CC the enemies who will be near said mobs, so they won't be able to act. Once you hit level 5, you'll be taking Power Up Punch and not Extreme Speed. Power Up Punch does more damage if you charge it up to a line, but does not gain damage afterward. You just hold it for the unstoppable and the damage reduction if you need it. Power Up Punch can only hit one target, and it has a priority system. If targets are really close to each other, it'll value the low HP target. However, I don't know if it prioritizes champions over monsters. I haven't been able to test that yet. So if anyone has tested that, let me know in the comments below. Once you hit level 11, it gives you Unstoppable, which is an insane upgrade. It is probably the biggest strength of Power Up Punch and what makes it so strong. And its cooldown is lowered when you hit other abilities such as Bone Rush. So you see it's on a 5-second cooldown right now. I use Bone Rush, it's back up. Power Punch is stupid OP damage. I'm sure you guys have all been one-shot by early game. That is something Extreme Speed cannot do unless you are near mobs, which is very easy to play around. You can flash towards the end of the punch, like so, to do damage and extend your range. I'm not sure if it damages everything that goes through your flash or if it just hits in a radius. Honestly, the radius is really big, so it's extremely hard for me to test. So once again, if someone knows how that works, let me know in the comments below. Power Punch also has a 2-second cooldown when canceled with your B, so you basically have like a no cooldown unstoppable that you can just spam and use to escape from any situation you want. It's also a no cooldown damage reduction. Almost makes Extreme Speed look kind of not that good, doesn't it? The second ability you'll be taking is one we demonstrated earlier, Bone Rush. Bone Rush is mediocre damage, however, it does have decent CC. It can be used to CC a lot of people. It is a teleport option, which is very strong. You can use that to juke people. And it also resets Power Up Punch twice if used at level 13. And you get one reset from actually using the Bone Rush itself. If you hit someone with it, every time you hit, it will lower Power Punch's cooldown. And then you get another reset from actually porting if you hit level 13 and have the upgrade on Bone Rush. Lastly, you have your ult. Your ult does okay-ish damage. It does damage in ticks, so the longer they sit in the ult, the more damage it will do. If they only get hit by like one proc of it, they will only take 900 or so damage, so not too much. It can be used to snipe across the map, but the main application of it is for buddy barrier and the buff it gives. When you use your ultimate, you get a buff to Power Up Punch, which would make your Power Up Punch do approximately 400 extra damage once you hit level 12. And then it also has the move speed buff slash tankiness buff you get from just casting your ults anyway. Lastly, let's talk about gameplay. I'm going to be telling you guys how I think you should be playing Lucario. First, you're going to be abusing his super strong early game, utilizing Meteor Mash's CC and Quick Attack's very fast hits to be able to last hit and deny the enemy EXP. Once you hit level 5, you can play extremely aggressively with Power Up Punch. You win every single 1v1 in the game at this point, assuming you hit your Power Up Punch, so do not be afraid to go all in. One of the main strengths of Lucario is being able to roam down for Dreadnought. You can instantly delete two people from the fight and secure it for your team. You can also use Power Up Punch to last hit the Dreadnought, and it is a very good secure, as most people won't have ultimates in the game at that point. In teamfights, you want to look to assassinate squishies such as Gengar, Cinderace, Greninja, Ninetales, and Cramorant. Now here are two tips I don't have gameplay footage for. In the later stages of the game, you can split push as ghouls start to become more and more effective. You're very tanky with your passive. You have three dashes using Power Up Punch, Bone Rush's reset, and Power Up Punch again. And you also have a score shield to help you be able to score as well. You can utilize Power Up Punch as unstoppable to move past tanks such as Snorlax and as well, Ninetales and her CC, in order to be able to assassinate the squishy backlane targets. That's it for this guide. Hopefully I cleared up any misinformation that was spread to you guys and left you guys more knowledgeable. If you guys have more ideas for content for me in the future, let me know in the comments below, and I'll see you guys next time.